Hey everyone, I'm meteorologist Matt Serwey. It is going to be a hot and humid afternoon, and we're already starting to see some clouds develop ahead of this cold front that's coming in. And these are the clouds that are eventually going to grow into some sort of thunderstorms. Just puffy cumulus clouds right now looking to the northwest from Papillion. Here's Highway 370 and 72nd Street. I'm pointing this off to the northwest so you can see that's where we do have those clouds developing. It's already 81. As of 10:45, south winds at about 15 miles an hour, and the dew point is in the low 70s, so well on our way to the hot and humid afternoon. Highs in the low 90s for a lot of us, might be some stuck in the upper 80s, but when you factor in the humidity, it'll feel like the upper 90s to around 100, even though storms are kind of the big takeaway in the forecast later on. Keep in mind that it might be a little tough to be outside. So if you're a parent who has a kid going to a practice after school, if you're a kid who has practice after school, first off, good on you for watching a forecast on a local news site. But stay hydrated. Make sure the kids are staying hydrated later on this afternoon. That goes for coaches as well. Now, as far as the actual storms, not much is happening right now, but you see off to our northwest, the front itself is still well to the west of this little line of clouds and rain showers that are developing. I think this first line that's coming through will die out. There might be a brief rain shower in Norfolk, in Pilger, possibly even West Point and Columbus, but that initial line should fizzle out early this afternoon. And then as the cold front comes through later on today, that's when we see our best chances for storms. Nevertheless, I'm going to keep an eye on that initial line as we go through the afternoon. I'm still not pushing up our rain chances just yet, but it's just something to watch. Along that front, the storms are capable of producing damaging winds, large hail, and there's a very low chance that there's a weak tornado north of Omaha. But by and large, this is going to be kind of a gusty wind event if we do see anything. The slight risk of severe weather in the yellow over most of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa, and the marginal risk closer to the Kansas and Missouri borders. Slightly lower chances for the big storms down there. So this computer model, it's doing a good job of picking up that initial line of clouds. It doesn't have any showers along it, but as we go forward this afternoon, notice how it kind of dies out, but there could be a brief rain shower off to our west. And then between 3 and 5 o'clock, you see the thunderstorms firing up along the cold front northwest of Omaha. And then anywhere between 6 and 10 o'clock is where we have the potential for stronger thunderstorms along the I-80 corridor. And then between 8 and midnight, if you live farther to the south or southeast. So you see, they're moving through very quickly. This isn't going to be an all-night type of thing. Heavy rainfall is unlikely with these storms as well. So just anytime late this afternoon and into the evening, make sure you're keeping an eye on the radar. If you have a softball, baseball game, if you have a golf league, if you have anything going on outdoors this evening, it's not a cancel plans type of storm. It's a make sure you have a place where you can jump inside for an hour to an hour and a half type of storm. And then once they move through, it'll turn less humid. And we stay less humid all the way through the weekend. Temperatures in the mid-80s, a lot of sun Saturday and Sunday. So the best way to stay informed of all the weather this afternoon, download the KETV mobile app. Keep an eye on that interactive radar. You can see the storms as they move in. Plus, if anything goes severe, that app will also give you the latest severe weather alerts. Notifies you right there on your phone. Meteorologist Lauren Robinson is going to update your forecast on NewsWatch 7 at noon. Meteorologist Sean Everson is going to be in later on today in case any of those storms do go severe. And of course, I'll always be blasting stuff to Facebook and Twitter as necessary. So just keep an eye on the storms this afternoon and this evening, and then enjoy a really nice weekend. Be safe, be smart, please wear a mask, and I'll see you Monday morning on First News.